Hello students, as you are observing on board, today we are going to discuss our new topic. It's a matter. As we know from the last classes that anything that occupies space and has mass. Occupies space, having some mass. Has some mass, this type of thing is known as your matter. Hope this one is clear to you. Anything that occupies space and has mass is known as your matter. In the light of modern research, there are some building blocks, basic building blocks known as your elements. In case of matter may be a unique one, pure substance, maybe impure substance, for example, maybe compound. That we are not going to discuss because this is a part of chemistry. But anything that occupies space and has mass is known as your matter. For example, this piece of chalk is also a matter. This piece of clock is also a matter as well. But these matter are made up of some basic building blocks. They are known as your elements. Some basic building blocks, and they are known as your elements. Till now, we discovered in our surrounding, we are able to find that there are 118 elements on our surface, in our neighborhood, are present. For example, iron, copper, all these things are your element. What are element? Element is defined as the substance which cannot be divided into two or more than two parts. Two parts means what? Two simpler substances. What is the meaning of your element? Elements cannot divide into two or more simpler substances. Two or more simpler substances, these are known as your elements. Hope this one is clear to you, matter and element. Now each and every elements further divided into smallest pieces. Each and every element, we can easily divide this piece of duster into very smallest part, up to a very smallest particle. We can break this chalk up to a smallest fine particles of the chalk. So there is a situation obtained. We reach up to a condition that after that we are unable to divide them. Such type of condition are known as we reach up to the subatomic part or atomic part. What is the meaning of atomic, or what is the meaning of atom? So from the definition we can say that atom is the very smallest part of an element. Definition says that atom is defined as the smallest unit of element. Smallest unit of element. Now, but there are some conditions. May or may not exist independently. May or may not exist independently. Mm-hmm. That's good. Okay, may or may not exist independently. Next one is there. Most important, take part in a chemical reaction. Always take part in a chemical reaction. So these, under these, including these three points, it is known as your atom. Hope this one is clear to you. Now come to the molecule. Atom is the very smallest part, but smallest part of what? Smallest unit of element. What about molecule? Smallest unit of compound, not in this case, not element, smallest unit of any matter. Molecule is defined as the smallest unit of matter. Matter may be some element, may be some compound. Compound means that substance made from two or more substances. Molecule is defined as the smallest unit of matter. It's the smallest unit of matter. The smallest unit of matter which exists independently. In this case, may or may not, but in this case of molecule exists independently. Now, then never take part in a chemical reaction. Not participate, the perfect word. Not participate in chemical reaction. Hope this one is clear. Not participate in chemical reaction. So this is some basics definitions of this. Next class we discuss about kinetic theory and topics of kinetic theory. This is we're starting part, so I make a short video. That's all for today. Thank you.